Do you think the Siberian tiger is the strongest in the world? You might be right, but not completely. The world of tigers is not just about white snow and bone-crushing bites. Each subspecies is a solitary warrior shaped by nature to rule over some of the planet's harshest environments, from mangrove swamps to misty deep forests, from frigid highlands to tropical jungles. But what if all of them stood on the same battlefield? Then who would truly be the king of the tiger family? Size, strike, bite force, survival skills, we have weighed them all. Let's dive into the ranking of the most powerful tigers on Earth. And a fair warning, some names you may have never even heard of. Number 6. The Malayan Tiger. Hidden deep in the tropical rainforests of Malaysia, the Malayan tiger is not the biggest of the bunch, but if you think that means it is weak, that would be your first mistake in the game of survival. With an average length of around 2.4 to 2.6 meters, or about 7.9 to 8.5 feet, and weighing roughly 100 to 140 kilograms, or about 220 to 310 pounds, the Malayan tiger has a lean body that moves almost completely silently through the dense jungle canopy. It is a ghost, a flash of black and orange darting through layers of shadow where light barely touches the ground. Unlike other tiger subspecies that hunt across wide plains or rolling hills, the Malayan tiger operates near rivers and swamps, places where every step must be precise not to disturb the surface of the water. Its greatest enemy is not another predator, but extinction itself. With fewer than 150 individuals left in the wild, it has become one of the hardest tigers to capture on film. Number 5. The Sumatran Tiger. Sumatra Island, Indonesia. A land shrouded in mountain fog and ancient trees towering into the sky, where even echoes are swallowed by thick vegetation. This is the kingdom of the smallest tiger on Earth, the Sumatran tiger. Weighing only about 100 to 140 kilograms, or approximately 220 to 310 pounds, it is often considered the tiny one of the tiger family. But make no mistake, small does not mean weak. Its compact frame allows it to climb trees, spring from bushes, and weave through thick jungle terrain without making a sound. Its strength lies in agility, combined with stealth and the ability to assassinate its prey. Sumatran tigers have been recorded taking down full-grown wild boars weighing nearly 100 kilograms or about 220 pounds with a single blow from a front paw. Thanks to webbed feet and superb swimming skills, Sumatran tigers are not afraid to chase prey across swamps or shallow waters, giving them a tactical advantage over many other subspecies. Trail cameras have even captured one tiger closing in on a deer standing nearly 30 meters or around 100 feet from the forest edge, needing just a few careful steps and one explosive leap to secure the kill. Today, fewer than 400 Sumatran tigers remain, but every single one is living proof of natural-born power, compact, agile, and incredibly precise. A silent assassin of the jungle, one that humans would forever underestimate if they judged only by size. Number 4. The South China Tiger. With a compact build, dense muscles, and powerful bursts of acceleration, the South China Tiger is a lethal predator across the rugged mountain forests of southern China. Males average about 2.3 to 2.6 meters long, or roughly 7.5 to 8.5 feet, and weigh between 130 to 175 kilograms, or about 287 to 386 pounds, not the largest species, but do not be fooled. They strike with lightning-fast reflexes and dead-on accuracy. When it leaps from the brush, a South China tiger can pounce as far as 10 meters, or about 33 feet, using its full body weight to slam down prey, often wild boars or golden deer. Its thigh-to-shoulder muscle ratio is considered nearly perfect for close-range ambush attacks. Its bite force is estimated between 950 to 1,000 pounds per square inch, strong enough to shatter shoulder blades or crush cervical vertebrae of large prey. That makes it one of the most efficient ambush hunters in steep, rugged environments where explosive power is the key to survival. In the early 20th century, there were reports of a single individual killing over 30 people in just 1 year, not because of bloodlust, but because habitat destruction forced it down into human settlements. A true tragedy of survival, driven by desperation and primal instinct. historical records note a South China tiger responsible for over 30 deadly attacks within a few months, triggering entire villages to evacuate. It stands not only as a testament to their danger, but also as a reminder, when the South China tiger turns predator of humans, its power is beyond ordinary control. Today, the subspecies is nearly extinct in the wild, with only a few dozen individuals held in captivity in China. But in history, it was once a symbol of raw strength, a close combat warrior that never needed a massive body to command respect in the food chain. Number 3. The Indochinese Tiger. The Indochinese tiger, Panthera. Tigris corbeti is perhaps the most mysterious and least documented of the modern tiger subspecies, but that very elusiveness makes it a powerful enigma in the natural world. Adult males average about 2.7 to 2.9 meters in length, or roughly 8.9 to 9.5 feet, and weigh between 180 to 250 kilograms, or about 397 to 551 pounds. The largest recorded individual found near the Vietnam-Laos border weighed a full 250 kilograms. Though not the heaviest, the Indochinese tiger excels at navigating mountainous terrain, ambushing in steep hills, and unleashing short-range attacks with explosive acceleration. Villagers near the border reported a male tiger killing more than 10 water buffalo in just 1 month. The wounds showed it did not use claws to drag the prey. It leapt from cover, locked onto the neck, and ended the fight with a single bite. A deadly precision like a sword master, striking only when a fatal blow is certain. It hunts large-hoofed animals like bantang cattle, young wild buffalo deer, and wild boars. Thanks to the thick jungle and rocky forests it calls home, the Indochinese tiger has developed an incredibly quiet movement style and flexible musculature. If we rank tigers by hunting effectiveness in rugged terrain, no other would top the Indochinese tiger. Number 2. The Bengal Tiger, India. Bangladesh-Bhutan regions where dry forests meet muddy mangrove swamps are home to the most famous tiger on earth, the Bengal tiger. These animals are not just strong, they are built to dominate the most densely populated ecosystems on the planet. On average, Bengal tigers weigh between 220 to 250 kilograms, or roughly 485 to 551 pounds, and grow up to 3.3 meters long, or about 10.8 feet. Their powerful hind legs allow them to tackle prey twice their size in a single burst. But what truly sets them apart is their ability to fight across terrains and against multiple enemies both on land and in water. In the Sundarbans mangrove forests where saltwater mud and tangled roots form a natural maze, the Bengal tiger is the only predator that dares to take on full-grown crocodiles. Trail camera footage has captured Bengal tigers breaking crocodile necks with their forelimbs or sinking their fangs into the throat of the reptile's only real weak spot. They can kill full-grown wild buffalo and drag carcasses much heavier than themselves for hundreds of meters without resting. Their hunting style is highly versatile. They may lie in ambush for hours beneath a swamp or sprint at up to 60 kilometers per hour or around 37 miles per hour to chase down prey. Number 1. The Siberian Tiger. No predator survives where temperatures plunge to minus 50 degrees Celsius except the Siberian tiger, the ruler of the taiga forests where snow, wind, and death reign. Adult males range from 3.1 to 3.5 meters long, including the tail, or about 10.2 to 11.5 feet, and weigh between 250 to 320 kilograms, or roughly 551 to 705 pounds. Some have been recorded at over 350 kilograms or 772 pounds. Their pounce hits like a hammer, generating up to 5,400 newtons of force, enough to bring down a large deer with one blow. The Siberian tiger also has one of the strongest bite forces among land predators, around 150 to 100 pounds per square inch. In the wild, there are verified reports of Siberian tigers ambushing and killing black bears and even brown bears by leaping from elevated ground, locking the prey's neck, and delivering a precision bite to the cervical spine. They have the thickest fur of all tigers, along with a layer of fat under the skin, which allows them to hunt, even when temperatures drop below minus 40 degrees Celsius. Their stamina allows them to stalk prey for hours in the snow, traveling 20 to 30 kilometers or about 12 to 18 miles each night in search of game like Manchurian deer, sika, deer wild boars, and even lynxes. In one famous documentary, a camera had to run continuously for more than 90 days just to capture a Siberian tiger stalking prey through the snow, a striking image of patience, intelligence, and the unmatched power of this wild king. But if you believe the Siberian tiger is the pinnacle of power, hold on. Because history once witnessed a tiger species that surpassed every modern standard, the Ngandong tiger, scientifically known as Panthera tigris soloensis. This ancient tiger roamed the earth around 195,000 years ago during the Pleistocene epoch, mainly across Southeast Asia, especially on the island of Java, Indonesia. Though all that remains today are fossils, what scientists have uncovered is enough to confirm this was one of the largest and most powerful tigers ever to walk the planet. Based on bone analysis, the Ngandong tiger may have reached up to 4.1 meters in body length, or about 13.5 feet. With a shoulder height of roughly 1.2 meters, or close to 4 feet, and an estimated weight exceeding 360 kilograms, which is more than 790 pounds, massively outclassing any living tiger species. With such an enormous physique, it could easily hunt gigantic prey like ancient rhinoceroses, primitive elephants, and even early humans such as Homo erectus creatures that lived during the same era in a damp, dangerous environment of sparse forests. True strength is not just in numbers or muscle, it lies in how a creature overcomes challenges to survive. That is what makes every tiger subspecies a glorious chapter in nature's grand epic. So what do you think, which tiger deserves to be called the strongest? Leave a comment below, because sometimes power lies in the way we tell and perceive the story. And do not forget to subscribe, share the video, and help spread the love for the wild before the final wonders of nature disappear forever.